back, and really, we've been below average temperatures, haven't we, for the last several days or so?
Yeah, actually, the past several days for sure. And really, what it's come down to is it ties into the fact that we've seen more cloud cover, a little bit more rain. It's harder to heat up when your surface is damp compared to a dry surface, but either way, the heat is just around the corner. As we go towards 4th of July weekend, weather that we would expect to see around here. Tonight, clear to partly cloudy skies for the second game of the College World Series, at least the championship series, that is. 79 degrees at 7 p.m. by 10 o'clock. Lower 70s, right around 73 with a southeast wind at 10 miles per hour. Let's take a look at how weather's affecting you. And beautiful for today. Minimal rain chances, not only today, but as we go towards Wednesday into Thursday as well. In other words, we're getting a little bit of a period to finally dry out a bit with hot and humid conditions on the way. A quiet scene right now locally, not a whole lot going on. And that's also the case, especially from, let's say, Nebraska, Iowa, northward. This is good. We don't want to see rainfall up in this region right now. And the good news is we'll get a break from that. Areas across the Dakotas, also into eastern portions of Montana, central Montana, down towards Wyoming, all drying out, which is good. Thunderstorms on the strong to severe side as we head further off towards the south. This will be kind of the focus today for severe weather. Nothing like that to worry about around here. The one thing that a lot of folks are worried about, though, the flooding stages setting up right there along the Missouri River, whether it's Brownville, Nebraska City, Plattsmouth, 10.4 feet above flood stage in Plattsmouth right now. The areas in red, that's where major flood stages are setting up. Moderate flood stages from Omaha northward. Keep in mind, Rulo's not on there, but I'll tell you what, that number right around 10 feet above the flood stage is about where Rulo, Nebraska sits as well, also tied in to that major flooding stage right now. Temperatures are looking like this. Lower 50s across much of the area. 59 degrees, though, right now at Omaha's Epley Airfield. And taking a look at temperatures across the area when it's coming down to the region, it's really just, it's 50 in Norfolk. Is there a chance that in between the hour we could have dipped back to the upper 40s? It's a possibility there. Otherwise, upper 50s once again in the metro. 52 from Harlan over towards Denison as well. 59, that's the air temperature at Omaha's Epley Airfield. The dew point at 54 degrees. Winds from the west at 3 miles per hour. And taking a look at our storm predictor model run, this is good because, you know, yesterday it was showing a lot of greens, a lot of yellows, a lot of reds. That ties into the precipitation. Not the case for today. Temperatures in the lower 70s by the noon hour. Let's jump ahead from noon to the 5 o'clock hour. And again, not a whole lot going on. That's quiet weather, maybe a high cloud here or there. Upper 70s by the 5 p.m. hour, certainly very nice conditions. Think about yesterday and kind of knock down the wind just a little bit and a few less clouds, and that'll give you an idea of how the forecast sets up for today. Now, as we go towards 10 o'clock for Tuesday night, mostly clear skies. Temperatures upper 60s to lower 70s across the area. And as we make our way, let's say, towards Tuesday evening all the way into Wednesday early morning, not a whole lot taking place yet. Again, it's nice to see Storm Predictor really not have much in the way of anything, whether it's clouds or precipitation, because that means we are getting a little bit of a break. There's a look at your 7-day forecast. Temperatures getting closer to 90 degrees on Wednesday, a little bit on the windy side. Temperatures starting off in the mid-70s. Thursday morning with mid-90s for daytime highs on Thursday. The heat index in the triple digits. That'll be really kind of just one of the first hot and real humid days of the summer. We did have a few 90s earlier in the year, but the reason that temperature was able to bump up a little bit is because our air dried out. So this time around, hot and humid around the corner with a few thunderstorm chances as we go towards Friday into Saturday as well.
Yeah, I've been waiting for it. Here it comes.